Hello students, today we are going to study about history chapter 6, towns, traders and craftsmen. In previous chapter we have learned about the buildings builders, isn't it? Then now today we are going to study about the town, traders and craftsmen. What is the meaning of town, traders and craftsmen, children? I'm sure you understood the what is the meaning of towns. During the medieval period, what happened? During the medieval period, new towns developed in a different parts of India. Different parts of India, there was a new towns were built up. Okay, these towns had different parts. Some were administrative, some were religious centers, some parts of towns had a commercial centers. Many towns combined with the several functions, like they were administrative center, temple town, as well as the centers of commercial activities and crafts production. So children, these towns were the different types. Some was religious, some were the commercial. These types of towns were built up during the medieval period time. Okay, now the administrative centers. Okay, now Thanjavur was the capital of Cholas. The capital of Cholas time, there was a one city, a town was that was the Thanjavur. And in that Thanjavur, the king of Raja Rajeshwar built this temple in the name of Rajeshwar. Okay, and this Thanjavur is situated near the, in the Tamil Nadu, okay? It is situated there and just near the Kaveri River, okay? The temple towns and pilgrimage center. The temple town represent a very important part of the urbanization, okay? These temples towns represent very an urbanization. The Thanjavur is the example of the temple town, okay? In Thanjavur, there is a lot of temples are there. During the Raja Rajeshwar Cholas time, there was a lot of temples were built over there. So that part was called, Thanjavur was called the temple town, okay? And with often central of the economic and society, rulers with temples dominated their devotion to the variety, various deities. There so many, in Thanjavur, there was so many kinds of temples were there and many people used to worship there as a different types of god over there. Settlement near the temples. Gradually large number of the priests, workers, artisans, etc. settled near the temple pilgrimage catcher to its needs, and those of the pilgrimage in this way, temple towns grew more. So what happened? Near the temple, wherever you must have gone, children, you must have seen the temple. Wherever the temples are there is always, there is a shop, there is a trade, workers are there, artisans are there, and priests are there, that sadhus. And because of these pilgrimage goes there, and they buy certain things, and that, because of that reason, that was called as a temple towns, okay? And nowadays, there is a temple towns are growing more and more. Township near the pilgrimage center, okay? Moreover, pilgrimage center also slowly developed into the township. It also, this developed, pilgrimage center also became and developed into the township, like Vrindavan, which is in Uttar Pradesh. We can see that is also in Ajmer. Ajmer is two types of religious places there. That is, one is a Pushkar for the Hindus, and there is a tomb also is there, that is for the Muslim, okay? And those time was the capital of the Chauhan king in the 12th century, and later became the Sabha headquarters under the Mughals. It is an excellent example of religious consciousness sufficient settled there in 12th century attack devoted from the all the creeds. Okay, in because of this there was a so many religious was came up in 12th century. A network of a small town. From 8th century onward, several small towns emerged into large villages. Small towns, it emerged into the large villages. This town usually had a mandapika to which nearby villages brought their produce to sell. Where the villages used to come and sell the produce in that place. And they also had a market streets called Bata, lined with the shops. Okay, with the lines, they used to keep sit and they used to take the shop was called Bata. There were different kinds of artisan like potters, oil preachers, sugar makers. There was a different kinds of people were there. Different kinds of artisans are there, like a potter maker. You know the potter maker? You must have seen in Meghnagar, in our own place, we can see little bit potter maker and the oil and sugar maker, okay? And these were grown up with a little town. It became these villages were there, but it turns into the become a little towns. Traders, big and small. Traders means what? Traders means a vyapari, okay? It's a vyapari. And then what happened? Traders coming from so many places, for the trading, okay? Like there were many kinds of traders, including the Banjaras, okay? There was a Banjaras. Now you can see every time, now and then you can see the people, Banjaras are coming with the several, with the camel and this thing, several other traders, especially horses traders, okay? Horse traders form association with the headman who negotiated on their behalf with the warriors who had brought horses. And so many places they have brought the horses for the traders, okay? Since traders had to pass through many kingdoms and forests, these traders, this vyapari has to pass through so many kingdoms and so many forests. They usually travel in caravans and formed guilds to protect their interests. The interest means the whatever things they used to come to sell over here. So they used to protect them properly. There were several such guilds in South India like Meghma and Nagdis. There were also communities like Gujarati traders, including the communities of Hindu, Banyas and Muslim Bora trade actually with the pores of the red soil. Okay, there were also communities like Gujarati traders. Gujarati traders, where they are staying? With the Gujarati traders in Gujarat. Okay, including the communities of Hindu. Okay, Hindu Banyas. Banyas, now you know that what is the meaning of Banyas, so I have nothing to tell about it. And Muslim Boras trade extensively with the pots of the red soil. They used to sell this kind of thing. Okay, the spices growth in tropical. The spices, what is the meaning of spices? That like pepper, cardamom, nugda, and ginger, dried ginger, etc. These things used to, these people, the European people used to like this dry fruit, dry masalas, and then they used to take over them and became, it is an import part of the import European country. Cooking and cotton cloths was very attractive. Okay, from India, there was a from the Indian, there was a spices. In India, there was a lot of spices grown. And the people used to do the craft work, like in cloth. that tie and dye. The European people appreciated that very much, and those tie and dye clothes went into outside country, European country, and they appreciated these clothes, and these clothes were very attractive. Craft in towns. The craftspersons were very famous. They were inclined lay work in the copper and silver came to be known as Bidri and panchayats of the Vishwakarma community. Vishwakarma community, they used to dial you must have seen the copper, silver, and this kind of statue they used to make during that time. And these people craft in the town, they used to make the statue of the all kinds of gods, and that was a very famous over here. And they used to goldsmith and this bronze smith, blacksmith mentioned, the carpenter played a very important role over here. Building the temple, construction of the place, big buildings, tanks and reservoirs. Okay, weavers like the slaves, some aspects of cloth making like the cotton cleaning, spinning and dyeing become the independent crafts. Okay, in a country, in India, there was a cotton cleaning, okay, spinning means a charkha, and then dyeing, that is a tie and dye, that cloth I already told you about the tie and dye. And even till today in India, that tie and dye cloth is very famous. And nearby, when you visit some places, I think you can see this tie and dye clothing, and it is a very good thing. And you also can try at home this tie and dye. Ask somewhere and see in the YouTube, and you can find and you can try to make this tie and dye cloth. Little cloth you just take and try to make it, okay? Then you will enjoy what is a tie and dye. Hampi. Now Hampi was a well fortified city, okay? Hampi was a well fortified city, and this the building in the royal complex had a splendid arches. Okay, this building Hampi was very big, and it was built with so many pillars. Okay, so many pillars and splendid arches. Okay, pillared and hall with the well-planted arches and pleasure. Hampi in its heyday is the 15th and 16th centuries, brushed with the commercial and culture activities. Okay. Now you see the culture activities at Hampi. Okay, culture activities. What was the culture activities was in Hampi? European traders dominated their markets of Hampi. Temples were the hub of the cultural activities, and temple dancer formed before the deity, royalty and masses. The festival of Navratri was very much famous for whom? This Hampi place people. This was a very famous for the Navratri was a very famous place. Things was there. This festivals was very much celebrated in the Hampi. Was one of the most important festival, and the celebrated at Hampi. However, Hampi lost its importance after the defeat of the Vijayanagara in 1565 by the Deccani. Sultanas, the rulers of Gaul, Kolkata, Binjapur, Ahmednagar, Birpura and Birdi. Now, this Hampi lost their traders after the rulers. Okay, they used to celebrate the festival of Navratri, and after that what happened? There was a Sultan ruled over there. then that was impact was gone little down. A gateway to the West Surat. Now children, this Surat, you may be heard about the Surat. Where is the Surat? Most of you have must have gone to the Surat and enjoyed that. And many traders came from the Surat via Surat. Okay, Surat in Gujarat was a important western trade during the Mughal period along the with the combined with the and Ahmedabad. Surat was a gateway for trade with the West Asia via Gulf of the Amzam. Okay, the Surat was the gateway of the trade. Okay, the many western people used to come to the Gujarat in Surat for the trading. It has also been called the gateway to Mecca because many pilgrim ships get sail from Surat. It is called the pilgrim ship set sail from the Surat. Why? Because many people came from the, it is called the gateway to Mecca because many pilgrim people came from the via from the West Asia to Surat to India. In 17th century, the Portuguese, Dutch and English had their factories and the village was at Surat. The textile of the Surat were famous for the gold lace border. Okay, this textile was there, gold border was there, and so this was very famous where in the Dutch time. Okay, Portuguese used to come from them. Who was the first person came who found the sea route first? The you may be knowing that because you have must have learned in the sixth class that who came first to the sea route to the India. Who was the that one first person? Yes, that was a Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama and Columbia was the first person who came to the India via sea route. There were magnificent buildings and innumerable pleasure park in Surat. Now you must have seen so many beautiful parks are there in Surat. Surat, and you can enjoy the life over there. When you go for picnic or anything, then you must have seen the so many parks in Surat. The state also built numerous restaurant house for the people who came here from all over the world. So many restaurants also is built, beautiful restaurants are built. Okay, beautiful restaurants also are built in Surat that many people come from outside of the country and our country also. Many people go can enjoy the parks and so many things in Surat. Now banking in Surat, the Kathiawar step, money changers had huge banking house Surat. There was a changing of money also was static in Surat only. It is a noteworthy that Surat hits it. Decline of market. However, Surat began to decline towards the end of the 17th century. Okay, decline it. Surat began to decline towards the end of the 17th century due to the loss of the markets and productivity because of the decline of the Mughal Empire. Now flashing in double waters, search for the sea routes. Now already I have told you that who came first to India by sea route. Who came first to India by the sea route? That was Vasco da Gama and Columbia. The 15th century, the European sailor undertook the advent of the sea route. Vasco da Gama and the Christopher Columbus were the first to come. The permanent people came to India. Vasco da Gama and Portuguese sailors was one of those who sailed across the Atlantic to Africa coast, went to the round, crossing over the Indian Ocean. They came through the crossing of Indian Ocean and they went back Portuguese to the Atlantic to the Africa coast. His first journey took more than a year. Whose first journey? The Columbia's journey took first. That he was thinking that India was a the world is around. So he took 1 year. He reached to Calicut, that is at present we call Calcutta. That is he came first in 1498. He was followed by the English. Dutch and French sailors, on the assumption of the earth was round. Okay, they used to think that earth is round, so they thought that they will reach to any place because the earth is round. The Christopher Columbus and Italians decided to sail westwards across the Atlantic Ocean to find a route to India. This Atlantic Ocean, Italian decided to sail westward side, that across the Atlantic Ocean to find the route to India. He landed the West India in 1492. In which century? In which year? 1492. He was followed by the Spanish and the Portuguese. Who occupied the large parts of the Central and the South America? They occupied the large part of the Central and the South America. Now new towns and traders came. In the 16th and 17th century, what happened? The 16th and 17th century, the new towns and traders came up. European countries were searching for spices. The European countries, people were searching for the spices and textiles. What is the textile? I already explained before to you. Spices, already you know the what is the spices, which had become a popular both in Europe and West Asia. Okay. The most of the popular thing was both what spices and textile was the most important and most famous things was there in West Asia and in Europe. The great Indian traders like Mulla Abdullah Ghaffar and Virjavira, who want a large number of ships combined with the English and French and Dutch. These people, two people, the Mulla Abdul Ghaffar and Vijayvira, they had a lot of number of, they own large number of ships and competed with the English and French people and Dutch people. Now, Indian craftsmen began to work on a system of advances given by the European agents. Okay, the advantage was given to the European agents. The Indian craftsmen give the work system to advance was given to whom? By the European to the agents, and they had lost their liberty to sell their own clothes or weaving their own designs. Okay, the Indian people has lost their own clothes weaving and their own designing. In 18th century, they saw the rise of Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, and which was nodal city of today. So children, now you know the trades, town trades and craftsmen, how it went throughout the in 8th century to 16th to 18th century, and at last it came At last it came to the 18th century and we lost our earning. What was our impact on the textile and the expenses? So this was the chapter today, and thank you and have a nice day. But still, my dear children, study well and don't say that we have to write the exam online. But children, for your future, please start learning and take little interest in everything, in all the subject, not only my subject, but in all the subject, take interest and do something best for you. And I have given you homework to do something, tie and die. If I meet you next time in the class, if you go to the 8th class also, I want to see that tie and die you have made at home. Thank you and have a nice day, children.